In this tutorial, I want to share with you how to use Waze to navigate as you travel from one place to another, from one state to another, from one location to another. So Waze is a very easy to use app that you can easily use it on your phone, and you can navigate, you can travel, and it will show you, it will connect you with the maps, and it can give you details as you navigate or as you travel from one place to another. It can even give you information about traffic, it can give you information about accidents or whether there is camera or anything ahead of you. It can give you a hint about what is happening in front of you because it uses the satellite imagery data. So to start with, if you want to use Waze, you can come to your Play Store as usual. You can click on Play Store and you can come over here to the search bar and you can just search Waze. Right, you can see it over here, Waze, GPS, maps, and live navigation. So you just click on it and then you can click on open, or you can click on install in your own case, because I've just installed mine, so that's why it's saying open. All right, so in your own case it's going to be install, so just install and let's try to open and see what happens. So you just click to open. Usually it will ask you to enable your GPS, to own your GPS. All right, so this is a new look, same ways. Dark mode is improved, so Waze is easier on the eyes. Set preferences in settings. So you may choose to go with the dark mode or with the light mode. So you can go to settings and you can see the difference. So this is only at night. You can have the option to use the dark mode, or you can set same as phone settings, so which is the light mode. Right, so over here, once you open your Waze, this is where it's going to bring you, and you're free to search where you are going. So this is the first question. Okay, where are you going, where to? So let's say for example we are going to Lagos in Nigeria, and it will quickly bring in, once you type Lagos, it will quickly bring in options, and by the right you can show you the distance required to get to that particular location. So for example, right now it's 699 kilometers to Lagos. Okay, this Lagos state, this Lagos street, Lagos street is not far from here. It's just the name of a street, which is 6.7 kilometers, and you have Lagos Island, which is still in Lagos state, and many more, right? So once you select Lagos over here, it's going to boot it and it's going to carve out the state or the particular location where you say you are going. So this is Lagos. So you can save this place by just clicking on this star, or you can click, already give you the highlight that it's about 701 kilometers. So you can just click and go. This is the right location over here. It has just pinpoint that location. This is Lagos, right? So you can start by just clicking on go. So you click on go and it will navigate and calculate the routes, right?
Let's take Malambudi Zaria Road and E1. This route is 233 minutes faster than Kaduna Yosh Highway E1.
Right.
So in 200 meters, turn left.
So to give you the right direction and the shortest distance, okay? This route that it has selected is 233 meters shorter than the actual one. It will take you 10 hours. It will take you 10 hours to get to Lagos, 10 hours, 2 minutes to get to Lagos. So over here, you can easily move. It will move as you move to whatever kilometers per hour you have. It is going to move, and you can see the directions over here, and you're free to come over here also, and you can enable the voice or you can disable it, right? So this is sound off. This is alerts only when there is any key message or notification. This is sound on. You can enable it to be sound on, and you can change the Waze voice over here. You just click and you see other readers as well. You can have Sarah, you can have Ben, you can have Jamie, you can have Amy, you can have so many of them, right? Even in Arabic, you can read for you in Arabic. So depending on what language you want to read, this is Arabic, even in Chinese, and many more languages, you can select the voice that should read for you. And then you can check out more sounds over here, and once you're done, you say okay, and once you start moving, it's going to start navigating accordingly. You're free to move in within the screen, zoom in or out to be able to see the total distance. For example, you can see the total distance once you zoom out. you should be able to see the total distance. Okay, to Lagos, you can see the route. This is Lagos and this is where you are coming from. So this is just the overview of the total distance, right? So this is how to move around with the map. And once you are satisfied with seeing the overview, you can always recenter to bring you back to where you are, and then you can start the journey accordingly. It will show you the right route up to that location. You're free to search for other features as well. Maybe you want to search for filling station, or you want to search for resting point. You can save a particular location, for example this Lagos. You can navigate, check the three dots, and you can set, you can send location, you can mark it as a new place, or you can get the info. You can find parking space as well, and put it on your route, and you can find different kind of routes and see, you can plan a drive and see, and you can remove it from your list, right? You can connect this to your calendar, or you can connect it to your Facebook and do quite a lot, right? So you can come to the settings over here at this GR box, and you can see the general settings. You can check, change the voice and sound. You can change, make it enable the battery saver from here, and you can check the navigation, vehicle details. Okay, you can put on all this, and you can toll passes and exemptions, alerts and reports, speedometer, you can be able to see it if you enable it, audio player if you enable, right? Notification, plan, drive, reminders, accounts and login, privacy and all that. So you can invite a friend to use Waze if you want. Okay, this is Waze Map Editor. You can edit the map as well and send logs, right? So you're free to change, check the settings and do quite a lot here. You can do quite a lot. Once you are done with your traveling, you can come over here and you can search for, you can see parking space, you can enable it in your route, you can see filling stations, you can see restaurants and many more. You can check over here, you can drive through petrol stations, food, coffee, shopping malls, pharmaceuticals, pharmacies, supermarkets, hospitals and urgent care, hotels and lodging, outdoor parks. You can enable all these within your route so it can easily identify for you. Okay, so you can save places, you can check out history, you can search contacts, you can check out history of the places you've gone to. Maybe you've gone to Lagos and Kaduna and whichever place you have been to, you can see them all over here. Alright, so this is how to use Waze, how to download and install it. And once you are done, you can come over here and click on this off icon to close it, and you have closed it to take you to your destination very easily. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit on how to use Waze to navigate, to get live location and navigate around as you travel from one place to another. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.